Continuing to our series of blockchain lectures. In today's video, we'll be seeing the definition of blockchain. What is blockchain actually? We'll be learning about the basic definition of blockchain. In another 15 minutes, I'll be describing the definition of blockchain in different terms. The same definition would be repeated 2-3 times, so that after viewing this lecture, what is blockchain is clear to you. The concept, the aim of today's session is to know about what is blockchain. We have already seen what is blockchain with the help of a simple story. Now it is the time to see it in technical terms. So let us proceed to know about what blockchain is. Before we concentrate on what blockchain is, let us think for 2 minutes that what was linked list. Linked list was a data structure having a node. The node connected with another node with the help of a pointer. It was a node which was connected with the next node, and the node was having two fields. One was the data and the second was the address of another node which was stored in the previous node. So linked list was a data structure having collection of nodes, therefore it was known as linked list. Similarly, blockchain, it is a chain of blocks, a block, another block, another block. So a chain of blocks becomes a blockchain. What basically blockchain is, we'll be seeing in the definitions of blockchain. But before we actually see the technical definitions of blockchain, you can compare blockchain like a multi-purpose tool. You must have seen a tool where there is a bottle opener also, a nail cutter also. So you can compare a blockchain with a multi-purpose tool because it can be used for various purposes. Blockchain can be used for various purposes. So it is a multi-purpose tool. Similarly, you can think of blockchain as an operating system. You can compare blockchain with the help of an operating system. As we have an operating system, similarly, we have a blockchain. On an operating system, we build certain things. We build different applications using an operating system. Similarly, using a blockchain, we build different applications over the blockchain platform. So blockchain is like an operating system. Blockchain is a multi-purpose tool. Blockchain is a platform where we build our applications. Blockchain is a technology with support to make applications in a non-trusted atmosphere. It gives a trusted atmosphere in a non-trusted platform where different parties do not know each other and they collaborate to work with each other and to build trust. They use the platform of blockchain. The application is built on the platform of blockchain. Remember, it is a technology which is used to build applications. How it was evolved has will be told in the history of blockchain, which you will see that what was the role of cryptocurrency and all, but currently blockchain is used to build applications. So let's focus on different definitions of blockchain. To begin with, as you can see on the screen, that these are some of the key terms which describes the blockchain. The first key term is a distributed ledger. What is basically a distributed ledger? A distributed ledger, you can compare it with a register whose copy is with different people and it is being updated at different people at the same moment. So different people, as we saw in the case of the society, different people of the society were having their own registers and keeping the record. So blockchain is a distributed ledger technology where the same register, the same ledger is distributed to different stakeholders. Over here, we call them nodes. The different participants of the blockchain The different computers of the blockchain are different nodes of the blockchain, and they have their copy of the ledger, and to make it legitimate, different complex algorithms are used, which we'll be dealing in the second unit. So distributed ledger is one of the keyword of blockchain definitions. Second part, which comes in the key terms of a blockchain, we can compare blockchain as a data structure. We can think of it as a data structure. What is a blockchain? Like linked list was a data structure, having different nodes connected with each other. Similarly, blockchain can also be compared as a data structure, where it is having different blocks holding the data and the blocks being joined with each other. The difference between the linked list and blockchain is that linked list was not distributed. It was not decentralized. Blockchain is distributed. It is decentralized. Another difference is, in the linked list, we were pointing to the next node. In a blockchain, it is pointing to the previous node. The blockchain, the block combines with the previous block. And there are many other things which we'll be seeing further when we move further. So blockchain can be considered as a data structure to record, to keep the records in a block. Now moving ahead, let's see another key terms which are there in the blockchain definition. Another very important key term is that we can think of blockchain as a database. What is blockchain? Blockchain is a database which is used to keep the records. A block is divided in several fields, where there is a field which is known as a transaction. The transaction keeps the record. A block contains n number of transactions. We'll be seeing further. A block can store n number of transactions. So what is basically a blockchain? We can think of blockchain as a database. Definitely, it is a permission-based database and an append-only database, where we can add a new block, but to delete a block or to change anything in the block which has already joined into the chain is very difficult. We do not say it is impossible, but it is very difficult. So this is another difference. In a linked list, it was possible to delete a node, but in case of blockchain, it is very difficult. It is almost impossible. So it is an append-only permission database. Now moving forward to another key term of blockchain, that is cryptocurrency. What is basically cryptocurrency? Is like we have an Indian currency in rupees, American currency in dollar. Similarly, the currency used in computers is a digital currency. In the video of blockchain history, we'll be talking about that in 1990s this digital currency came into the picture, and blockchain uses the concept of cryptocurrencies to build applications, though it is not used by all the platforms. As I already said, we can compare blockchain as a platform. We can compare blockchain as an operating system. So there are different blockchain platforms. All the platforms do not use the concept of cryptocurrency, but still this cryptocurrency is one of the major key terms when we speak about blockchain. So having said all this, we can conclude with the first slide. We'll be seeing with more slides that what is blockchain. Blockchain is a database. Blockchain is an operating system. Blockchain is a data structure. It is an append-only database. It is immutable ledger, a distributed ledger which we cannot change. Something, a block has joined into the chain, we cannot change that block. We cannot delete that block. Therefore, it becomes an immutable blockchain. A block joins with another block. In it joins with the previous block using some complex mechanisms, using some complex algorithms, using some complex cryptographic hashing techniques, which will be dealt in further videos. Now, to move forward, let us see other definitions of blockchain to understand blockchain in much more detailed way. We'll be focusing on some of the definitions of blockchain, which has been given in different platforms, which has been given in different literature. So I'm sharing some of the blockchain technical definitions with you now. As the slide says, a blockchain is essentially a database where information is chronologically stored in continuously growing chain of data blocks. A blockchain is a database. Information is stored in the form of a chain which is continuously growing. It is implemented in a decentralized network. We always say that blockchain is a decentralized distributed network. So it is implemented in a decentralized network in a way which creates data integrity, trust, and security for the nodes without any need of central authority or intermediary. This is the key point of blockchain, that it gives us the trust, integrity of the data. How this trust is given, how this integrity is given, will be seen in further videos. But the basic concept of blockchain, the strength of blockchain is, it gives the trust and the integrity so that people who do not even know each other can collaborate in an application. And this all things happen without any need of any central authority, without any need of any intermediary. For example, now currently if I have to transfer some amount of money from my account to someone else's account, I need the central authority, the bank. In case of blockchain, no central authority is required. So it does not require any intermediary in between. This is the power of blockchain. Let's see another definition of blockchain. Blockchain can be regarded as a global spreadsheet or an incorruptible digital ledger where financial transactions, any data or asset can be represented, shared, and transacted with. What does it mean? We can consider blockchain as a spreadsheet, like a Google Sheet. The difference between a Google Sheet and a blockchain is, though it is distributed, many parties can work on the Google Sheet. But in a Google Sheet, we can corrupt it, we can change it. Over here, it cannot be changed. And it can record any type of transactions. And these transactions can be represented, shared, and transacted with any person. So this is the power of blockchain. Another definition of blockchain. Let's proceed with another definition of blockchain. Simply defined, we can say blockchain is little more than a distributed, secure log file. So nothing to worry. What is blockchain? It is a distributed, secure log file. Let's see what does Wikipedia says. Wikipedia says that blockchain is a continuously growing list of records called blocks, which are linked and secured using cryptography. The security of blockchain lies in the cryptographic concepts of the blockchain. Now, to summarize the definition of the blockchain, I have summarized it in my own words, that blockchain is a cryptographically secured record of transactions stored on decentralized network, where each block contains various transactions which are approved after complex consensus algorithms. What is blockchain? It is a cryptographically secured record of transactions. It is a record of transactions and it can be used for any applications, and those transactions are all cryptographically secured. A block joins into the chain only after complex algorithms. What are these complex algorithms? We'll be seeing afterwards. Like in our story, we saw that we write in a ledger when 50% of the people in the society agree to write, then only records are written in the register. Similarly, in a blockchain, a block joins in the chain when a complex algorithm has been approved, has been run, and the block is approved. To summarize, a blockchain is a cryptographically secured record. Blocks can join, but it is very difficult to change. It depends on the type of blockchain. So we say that it is almost immutable and impossible to change the record of the blockchain. Having said all this, what is blockchain is being covered in this video. Now we know what is blockchain, what is the technical definition of blockchain. So keep learning and keep enjoying blockchain.